Let's learn IIB. Today, I'll show you how to use TCP/IP monitor from IIB toolkit. All Eclipse toolkits have this feature. With this monitor, you would listen on some port for incoming traffic and pass the data along to another port, an outgoing port. This will help you inspect the traffic flowing through your IIB application. Observe that the data you passed to the REST request node and the response you got back, they both are captured in TCP/IP monitor. But you do not see the HTTP headers in full. I have set content type to URL encoding in eSQL. It is not visible in request data captured in TCP/IP monitor. You may also use other tools such as Burp Suit, Wireshark, so on. They will capture HTTP headers. To inspect the data flowing over the wire, you need these tools. Here, I get to see the content type of the header. HTTP header is populated as x-url encoded, exactly like the value that I've set in eSQL. Installing these third-party tools might not be allowed in your organization, or you might not have admin privileges to do so. So I created a mock service in IIB to inspect the contents. We will use the debug mode. In debug mode, we do not see X query string HTTP header, which we set in output local environment .rest.parameter. The reason is Swagger document used to define the mapping for REST API does not contain these query parameters defined in eSQL. Let's fix that now. In this picture, you see that I have added two query parameters, one of type integer and the another of type string. The values set in local environment are reflecting in debug view. The issue was that the parameters that we set in local environment were not getting mapped to parameters in Swagger definition. Now that I have modified the Swagger definition, we can see the REST parameter being populated, being propagated to the mock service as X query string HTTP header. For today's demo, I have used two projects from my GitHub repository, mock service underscore app and noMQ underscore app. Link to the source code in video description.